Rufus.
Nigger same, nigger same, nigger same.
Rufus, Rufus.
Nigger, nigger, black as top. Trying to ride an electric car. Car broke down and broke his back. Poor nigger wanted his nickel back.
I'm Rufus.
Oh, a Rufus, a Rastus, a Johnson, a Brown. What you gonna do when the right comes around? Rufus, a Rastus, a Johnson, a Brown. What you gonna do when the right comes around? Nigger same.
What in the world are you doing, Google Eyes?
I wish my name were Google Eyes.
No, you don't, because that's a funny name. You wouldn't want to be called by a funny name, would you?
Rufus is a funny name.
No, honey, it ain't.
It's a nigger's name.
Look, we got a nice clear day for the outing, don't we? You can see all the way to North Knoxville. And if you squint your eyes, you can see the North Pole. Squint your eyes. See the pole? And see that puff of smoke coming up over the hill? That means there'll be a train along the viaduct in a minute to the 107.
Rufus!
Mama's calling me.
Let's just watch the train go by. You know, Rufus is a very fine old name, Rufus. Some colored people take it too, but that's perfectly all right. Nothing for them to be ashamed of, or for white people to be ashamed of to take it. You were given that name because it was your great-grandfather Lynch's name. Your mama's grandfather. It's a name to be proud of. You're proud of it, ain't you?
Yes, sir.
Well, then you got to stand up for it. Can you spell brave?
B-R-A-V-E.
Now proud.
P-R-O-U-G.
That's the one. Just keep spelling that.
P-R-O-U-G.
You know what I'm proud of?
Mama.
You too. Why, you're only 6 years old and you can read and spell better than I could when I was twice your age.
I wish you could be proud of me because I'm brave.
One of these days you'll get those boys to shake you by the hand. When a man shakes you by the hand, that means you won him over. Now hold on there. You only got me by the ends of my fingers. Push your thumb clear up against mine. That's it. Now wrap your fingers as far as you can around the palm of my hand. Right to the other side if you can. Now squeeze. Not too much. That's just bragging. Just enough to show you mean what you're doing. Now shake. There she goes. Right on time. Oh, I hear them train cars rumbling, and they're mighty near at hand. I hear them train cars rumbling, come rumbling through the land.
Get on board, little children, get on board. Little children, get on board. Little children, there's room for many and more. Oh, I look away down yonder, and what do you reckon I see? A band of shining angels are coming after me. Get on board, little children, get on board. Little children, get on board. Little children, there's room for many and more.
Here comes the 107.
Don't you go away, Rufus. Your dad and people will be here in a minute.
Ralph just called up on the telephone.
Where from?
You know, Ralph, he wasn't 10 blocks away, just downtown. But instead of coming right on, he went through all the trouble of parking the machine, going in someplace, and calling to say they were almost here.
Do you ever know anyone who gets up and kicked out of telephones?
Well, if you ask me, he was in a saloon. Probably didn't want a telephone at all, if you know what I mean, but used it as an excuse to Sally for stopping. Well, once he was there, he felt he'd better really call her, so Sally found out from us if he didn't, and then she'd know that wasn't why he stopped.
You sure can't complicate a thought, Mama.
You know what I mean.
Did it say anything about knocking Cousin Wilhelm's block off?
No, thank goodness, he was very pleasant.
Well, then I reckon we'll still have a nice day.
When they get here, Jay, you won't let Ralph influence you, will you?
Oh, I might hoist a few with him.
Jay?
Sure, you and others go on to great-grandma's. I figure Ralph and I'll stay behind and have ourselves a bender. I'm just Ralph.
Don't say that, even if fun.
Oh, now, Mary, you don't ever worry about me anymore, do you?
I just don't like jokes about that particular subject, that's all.
Come on, you know what I don't like. Superintendents, no sir. I don't like people looking down on me and thinking I gotta keep an eye on them.
Was I looking down on you?
Why, you was about 10 feet off the ground.
Honestly, Jake?
2 feet.
Well, shame on me, and I certainly thank you for pointing it out.
I got a girl and a sugar babe, too.
Oh, that awful song.
I guess I know how to get on the good side of you now, don't I?
I guess you do. Well, I certainly hope the neighbors enjoy that.
think about starting a collection of pop scrapelings?
Scrapelings?
For
really,
sure,
James.
That's what they're called. You wrap them up in a little piece of paper, and you mark them with the date and whose pop they come out of. Then you put them away in some secret hiding place where no one will ever find them.
All right, Jay.
Please, ma'am. May I?
Of course you may. Just don't spill them all over everything. And get your feet off your daddy's chair.
Don't make your mama pick up after you, Rufus. What is it, honey?
Oh, I just got dizzy for a moment.
Here, you sit right down.
What's the matter, ma'am?
You all right now?
Of course I am. It was just a thing of the minute. It's to be expected from now on.
What's the matter?
Mama just stopped over very quickly and it made the room go round, that's all.
It's not going around.
Not for you, dear.
Why don't you tell him, Mary?
Oh, Jay, please.
Tell me what?
There, you see?
Well, he's got to find out sometime.
But not now.
Won't be long before he sees for himself that something's happening.
Not if you don't bring it to his attention.
I'd have told him weeks ago if you'd have let me.
I wanted to talk to Father Jackson first.
You don't need any priest to tell you how to talk to your own boy.
I just don't want him asking Q-U-E-S-T-I-O-N-S.
That won't do you any good, Mama. He can outspell the both of us put together.
I can get dizzy on a swing. Or if I turn around in circles fast like this. Look, Mama. I get dizzy. Look.
Rufus. Rufus, come here to Mama. Rufus, after a while, you're gonna have a wonderful surprise.
Like a present?
Something. Only very much nicer.
What's it gonna be?
Well, if I told you, it wouldn't be a surprise now, would it?
Will I get it today?
No, dear. Not for a long time yet.
When summer vacation starts?
Not till after summer vacation ends and you're gone back to school. Not even till after you cut out your pumpkin for Halloween.
Where's it now?
Up in heaven. Still up in heaven.
Tell him it's here with us, Mary.
Right here.
For the next few months, Rufus, you and I gotta take very special care of Mama. We gotta treat her like something that might just break.
I think we told him enough for the time being. He knows there's a surprise coming for us from heaven, and he has something to look forward to.
We don't tell him all of it, honey. The older boys in the streets will. Would you like that?
What if I know?
Nothing, dear. Nothing at all.
Is the cat, ma'am? Is the surprise okay?
Rufus, I told you again and again, you can't have one of those cheap flasher cats. And I told you to stay away from those rowdy boys.
And what if they won't stay away from him?
Now, darling, will you do Mama a favor? There's a hamper on the dining room table. Will you take it out so it'll be ready to put in Uncle Ralph's car?
Do I have to?
Do what your mama says, Rufus. I think it'd make him feel more grown up if he had a cap like the older boys.
He's not grown up, Jay.
Sure it's hard for a fellow to know where he stands around here. You should tell him to stay away from those older boys. I tell him to win him over. You say a surprise up in the sky someplace. I say it's right here on Earth. Yes, sir. Sure it's hard for a fellow to know what's going on.
He's just a child.
All that about priests and heaven. Sets my teeth on edge.
Oh, gee, sometimes I pray.
That's your privilege.
Now I can't say what I was going to say.
I'm listening.
But you're keeping your distance. As you always do when these things come up. There's a space of about 100 miles between us.
And you've got that pursed up look. That preachy pursed up look.
When the baby comes, Jay, it'll be time enough for him to hear about it.
Sure, Mary.
I thought we'd have something cold to drink before we start. Oh, Lord, in thy mercy, who can do all things, close this gulf between us. Make us one in thee as we are in earthly wedlock. For Jesus' sake, amen.
Sure is Ralph getting out. Hey there, Ralph.
We made it, Jay, safe and sound.
Well, where'd you get the car?
You like her?
The Shamlin's, ain't it?
Oh, it goes like 60, Jay.
Well, what are you trying to do, make me look like a piker?
Well, you're a piker. You piker with your old tin Lizzie. How you been, sweetheart?
I'm fine, Ralph.
I gotta hug you, just gotta hug you. You can hug Sally if you want to, Jay. Everybody hugs my wife.
I thought we'd have something cold to drink before we start.
Did I do something wrong, Mary?
Goodness, no. Just tell the rest of them to get out of the car before they suffocate.
Come on, everybody. Mary's got us a glass of something cold. Wait. And isn't it just like you, Mary? I was saying to them as we were driving along, I bet Jay's wife thinks of having something cold waiting for us.
Daddy!
What is it, honey? What's wrong? What's the matter, honey?
Oh, Jay, you ought never to call a boy honey.
Come on, blow. You know your ma don't like you to swallow that stuff.
What is it?
I reckon it ain't fit for a lady's ears, Mary. Maybe you better turn your back.
Oh, for goodness sakes.
Now tell Daddy. Is that all? Why, is that all it is?
What is it, Jay?
It seems Rufus here just had a little accident.
Accident?
Did my Jim Wilson hit him? Because if he did...
No, nothing like that, Ralph. You know, Mary, an accident.
Oh, Rufus, you're too old for that. And I had you all dressed up for your daddy's people. Jay, you're going to have to help him change.
He's old enough to manage by himself.
That kind of an accident?
Must have been the excitement of the day.
Oh, that's rich, that is. Rufus is a baby. Rufus is a baby.
That'll do, Ralph.
Did you hear that, everybody? Rufus had an accident. That's how my chandlers affects people. They take one look at it and wet their britches.
Ralph.
Pee in their pants.
I'll take that.
Find a chair for Pa to sit down, Jay. He shouldn't stand around too much.
Get it over with.
Now, this is what I like. All the fathers
take us up home.
Guy.
All right. Oh, Mother Father.
Where are you going, Sally?
Thank you, Sally.
I asked you where you were going.
Mary, I'm taking Jim Wilson to the bathroom.
Not that we're
going to have an awful accident.
I'd just like you to answer me when I ask you questions. You hear me, Sally? I'd just like you to answer me when I ask you questions.
Sit right down here, Paul, and rest yourself.
Would you like something cold to drink, Mother Folly?
Wait on Paul first, if you will, Mary dear. I know how parched he gets. How's your breathing, Paul?
Pretty fair.
Well, you haven't had any more of your attacks, have you, Paul?
Well, not since that time last fall, Jay.
Well, Ma sure does spoil you, then.
That's how you do when you come close to losing someone.
Some life, I'll say.
Oh, I'm sure Mary spoils you enough.
Oh, no, I think Jay spoils me.
And so he should with another baby on the way. It don't show you, do it, Mary? Some show early, some show late. Ralph showed almost before I knew he was there. Jay, you was a kicker. Y'all right, Paul?
Pretty good.
Ralph, are you in there?
I'll be right with you, Mary.
Would you like some lemonade?
Well, thank you, Mary. I'm dry as a bone.
Well, things must be going pretty good for you, Ralph, if you can afford to go out and buy new chandlers.
Oh, yes, Jay. Why, considering the state of the world and all, Ralph Follett's doing fine. Just fine. All right, Ma, so I borrowed the money. But in this day and age, you've got to be in sound financial situation to borrow money. Jay, I walked in Ed Briggs' office in the Bank of La Follette, and he said, you want to buy a car, Ralph? Take whatever you need. That's how highly thought of I am in that bank.
I'm surprised they didn't just give you the keys to the safe.
Did you hear what Jay said? Well, I reckon Ed Briggs knew what he was doing. An undertaker's always a good risk.
It wasn't that, Paul.
I'm trying to give you a compliment, son.
Your Paul's right. Only thing you can be sure of in this life is people go on dying.
Mother Folly. I'd rather say they go on being born.
That too, Mary. They got to be born before they can die.
Ed Briggs gave me the money because it was me asking for it. There's other undertakers in La Follette he wouldn't give the time of day to.
Just the same, Ralph. Your pa never owed a cent in his life. Did you, Pa?
I'm even thinking maybe the farm will be free and clear before I die, Jay.
Now, you worked hard for it, Pa.
You owe any money, Jay?
What if he don't? I happen to want to give Sally some of life's refinements. I don't like the idea of my wife riding around town in some old tin Lizzie.
Why, Ralph, I just love our Ford. Well, I never get to ride around town in anything. He's always off someplace. He only bought that new car because of you, Jay, so he'd have a better one than yours.
And don't let him tell you any different.
Well, I certainly am anxious to widen it, aren't you, Jay?
I just can't wait.
And what are you doing at home while I'm out in the car on business? Just tell me that.
Well, why don't we get started? Rufus?
You see, the trouble with my wife is she don't appreciate how I try to please her. You ask Ma the things she's had to do without all her life and see how lucky you are.
That's one thing I can do without any more of this talk.
Sure, come on, Ralph. We all been looking forward to having a good time today.
I'm having a good time. Get out here, Jim Wilson. Start enjoying yourself.
Would you
Would you like some lemonade, dear?
My God, she just gets them all drained out, she fills them up again.
Rufus is a baby, Rufus is a baby.
Please, Ralph, that's enough of that.
Rufus is a baby.
Ralph, you're gonna stop.
I'm just teasing, Mary.
Well, you stop it, whatever it is. The child had a perfectly normal accident.
Why, Jim Wilson hasn't had an accident like that in years, and he's younger than Rufus by 11 months.
I don't care what Jim Wilson does.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean that, of course, Sally.
Aunt Mary cares the world about Jim Wilson.
God damn it, why isn't everything I say today is getting me into trouble?
And I thank you not to take the Lord's name in vain.
This family ain't Catholic, and I'll take the Lord's name any way that comes to mind.
You sure do like to hit all the bases, don't you, Ralph?
I'm sorry for what I said, Jay. Mary. Mary, Jim Wilson does pee in his pants every day without fail.
Then I think you ought to get Rufus out here and apologize to him for making fun of him.
Sure, Jim. Of course.
Rufus? Are you in there, Rufus? This is your Uncle Ralph calling to you. I promise not to tease you anymore. Do you hear me, Rufus? Oh, now there he is. Looky here. I got something for you. Take it. Ralph Follett, mortician. Friends again? Whoa! Now that's what I like. Everybody's friends again. All Follett's are friends, ain't we, Mary?
Of course, Ralph.
We're gonna get there this afternoon. We best get started.
Ma's right. Come on, everybody. Pile in the shamblers. Jay, you and Mary sit up front with me. And Rufus, you can sit on my left, Rufus. And maybe I'll even let you steer.
I think Jay ought to drive, Ralph.
My car.
You ain't no fit condition to drive it.
Well, nobody else is gonna drive it, I'll tell you that. Not my car.
Jay, can we go in your car?
His old tin Lizzie, we couldn't even all fit in it.
I'd rather be a little bit crowded, Ralph, and go with Jay in his car.
Oh, Jay this and Jay that. Everybody always looking up to Jay, asking Jay's advice, letting Jay do the driving. But let me tell you, there's been times when you wouldn't ride with him neither. He's been hauled out of the gutter more times than you can count, put in jail and worse.
You just go along in your shamblers, Ralph, and the rest of us will go with Jay in his car.
And you'll be sitting up there next to him, I suppose, rubbing legs with him. So it's Jay you're after now?
That thought never once came into Sal's head. You know it, Ralph, so dry up.
Don't think you're the only one she's after. Don't get no swell then. It's just you. It's any man with a flat belly. That's who it is. Andy Manning. Oh, so long as his belly don't get in the way. God damn you, flat belly. You know, I've a good mind to go over there and punch that Kaiser Wilhelm in the nose, and then maybe the Lottie would treat me with a little respect.
Better let me make you comfortable again, Paul.
Every time he sets out to enjoy himself, he just gets so unhappy.
I'll look after him, Jay.
I reckon you've had to do enough of that kind of looking after people. For your time.
Smell my hands, Jay. Go ahead, smell
them. There's nothing on your hands, Ralph.
Yes, there is, Jay. It's that formaldehyde. I can't smell it, but everybody else can. I scrub them and I scrub them. I can't ever get rid of that smell. Last night, I went to the picture show. I was sitting there next to this girl, and she got up and moved. It was that smell, Jay, don't you think?
Now, go on, Ralph. You're the worst tail chaser in La Follette.
That smell will make a move, I tell you. It's terrible to work with every day of your life. And then even when you go out for a good time, they have it go along with you. Picture show. The picture show was good, though. Charlie Chaplin. You like Charlie?
I sure do.
Why, last night he put a bag of eggs in the seat of his pants, and then he sat on them.
Rufus and I seen that one.
Oh. Well, you and I like lots of famous things, Jay. Maybe we're more brothers than we seem.
Now, I reckon people know we was brothers.
Well, now, thank you for that. You know, outside they're thinking that he's been in there long enough for two drinks, and I've only had one. If that's what they're gonna think, I might as well have two.
Now, you sure can't hold it, Ralph.
Help yourself.
Everybody's waiting on us, Ralph.
Go on, Jay Merrick. See, I tell you what, I'll keep watch for you.
It ain't that.
So goddamn reformed, ain't you?
Now, I'm just thinking of you. If you keep pulling away at that bottle, it ain't gonna last you through the day. And I know the feeling when the bottle's empty and you ain't full.
I want it to be empty, Jay. I'm no good when I'm like this. No good at all. I'm mean and I'm reckless. I'm not even real. I wish that this bottle was empty.
There. Empty. Are you ready to go now?
How's it make you feel, Jay?
That little bit don't make me feel anything.
Well, if you had a lot.
But come on, Ralph. It's getting late. We're gonna get to Great Grandma's back before dark. We gotta start.
I am not moving from this spot till you tell me how it makes you feel.
Well, if I had a lot like you, Ralph, I'd go quiet. So quiet I could hear the ticking of the earth. And I'd be as young as ever I could remember. Nothing bad had ever happened to me, ever would. I'd dare talk to no one, of course, for fear they'd show me the lie. And after a while, I'd get lonely in there all by myself, and I'd go off like a firecracker. If you were standing close by, you'd get a few powder burns, I'ma tell you.
What made you change, Jay? Was it Mary's religion?
Mary's religion is her own.
How'd you do it then?
I made a vow with myself. I said if I ever got drunk again, I'll kill myself.
Oh, Jay, that's a strong vow.
Couldn't afford to leave myself any loopholes.
Well, don't you ever get thirsty.
There's too many reasons why I don't want to kill myself.
Well, what are these?
And there's two out in the yard right now. As a matter of fact, 2.5.
Daddy!
Now, come on, Ralph. I promised them an outing today. They've been looking forward to it for weeks. I don't want to disappoint them.
Well, I got reasons out in the yard, don't I, Jay?
Yeah, wipe off your face. You worked yourself into a sweat.
Well, I could take that vow of yours, couldn't I, Jay?
Nobody's gonna try and stop you.
Well, I'm taking that vow this minute. Stand back!
Jay?
Maybe I could just take a vow that if ever I get drunk again, I'll take your vow.
You better think on it, Ralph. That's a pretty serious step.
All right. I hereby take a vow to think on it.
Hey, good for you. All set, everybody?
Whose car are we taking?
Why, the Shamblers, of course. I wouldn't pass a chance of riding the Shamblers.
But I've asked Jay to do the driving. I'm gonna ride on the running board.
Oh, Ralph.
Well, I got to point out the route to Jay. I'm the only one remembers how to get there. Take you riding my car, car. Take you riding my car, car. Take you riding my car, car. Take you riding my car. Front seat, back seat, blow the horn. Front seat, back seat, blow the horn. Front seat, back seat, blow the horn. Take you riding my car.
Take you riding my car, car. Take you riding my car, car. Take you riding my car, car. Take you riding my car.
Be sure you do remember, Ralph. We don't want to get lost up in those mountains.
There used to be cats back in those mountains. Only we called them painters then, Rufus. That's the same as a panther.
Well, they was there when I was a boy, Paul. And there still is bear, they claim. Now, don't you fret, Jim Wilson. We ain't likely to see any.
When was the last time you all saw Great-Grandma?
I was the last one to see her. I come out one day about 20 years ago.
20 years? Why, you certainly have a wonderful memory to find the way.
I've always had a pretty good memory.
Why, that's remarkable.
Jay, when was the last time you saw Great-Grandma?
I'm a-studying it. Well, nearly 13 years. The last time was right before I went to Panama.
Well, then you were the last one to see her.
Wait a minute. Seems to me I've seen her since then. There it is.
You sure that's the place, Ralph? It don't look like I remember it.
Yeah, that's it. That's it, all right. Why, sure. Only we come up on it from behind.
She doesn't live there alone, does she?
My sister Sadie gave her life to her. She wouldn't come to live with any of us. I raised my family in this cabin, she said. I lived all my life from 14 years on and aimed to die here. That must have been a good 35, most a good 40 years ago. Grandpa died.
Goodness sakes, and she was an old woman then.
She's 103 years old. 103, 104, she never could quite remember for sure which. But she always knew she was born no later than 1812. And she always reckoned it might have been 1811.
You know what she is, Rufus? She's Grandpa Farley's grandmother.
That's a fact, Rufus.
Would have never believed you'd hear me call anybody grandma now, would you?
No, sir.
Well, you're gonna.
Are you listening to all this, Jim Wilson?
She's an old, old lady.
Oh!
Lord God! Lord God!
Howdy, Sadie.
Howdy, John Henry.
Thought maybe you wouldn't have known us.
Oh, I know you all the minute I laid eyes on you. Just couldn't believe it. Howdy, Jesse.
It's nice to see you, Sadie.
Howdy, Aunt Sadie.
Howdy, Jay. You Jay's brother?
I'm Ralph, Aunt Sadie.
Howdy, Ralph.
This is my machine we come in, and this is my bride, Sally. That's how I kind of figure her.
Pretty.
Aunt Sadie, this is Mary. Mary, this is Aunt Sadie.
I'm proud to know you. I figured it must be you. And Rufus.
Say hello to Aunt Sadie.
Howdy, Aunt Sadie.
Jim Wilson, step up and kiss your Aunt Sadie. Give her a hug. This is my boy, Aunt Sadie.
Howdy.
How's Grandma?
As good as we got any right to expect. But don't feel put out if she don't know none of yous. She might, and she might not. Half the time, she don't even know me.
Poor old soul.
So if I was you all, I'd come up on her kinda easy. Been a coon's age since she seen so many folks at once. Me either. Might scare if y'all come whooping up on her in a flock.
Now why don't you go first, Paul? You're the eldest.
Tain't me, Schmaltzy. It's the young'uns that tickle her most.
Reckon that's true. If she could take notice. She sure liked to crack her heels when she heard your boy was born. Proud as Lucifer, cause that was the first.
I know. Fifth generation that made.
Sally and I lost the baby the year before Rufus was born. That would have been the first.
She always seemed to take a shine to you.
I always did take a shine to her.
Did you get her postcard?
What postcard?
When your boy was born.
Why, no.
She told me what to write on one of them postcards and put it in the mail to both of yous, and I done it. Didn't you never get it?
That's the first I've heard tell of it.
What street did you send it to, Aunt Sadie? Because we moved just before Rufus was born.
I never sent it to no street. Never knowed I needed to, Jay, working for the post office.
No, why, Aunt Sadie? I quit working for the post office long time back. I'm in law now with Mary's pa.
Well, I reckon that's how it come then, because I just sent it to Post Office Cristobal, Canal Zone, Panama. And I spelt it right, too. C-R-O.
Oh, why, Aunt Sadie? I figured you known I was living in Knoxville since before I was married, even.
Well, they might just as well put me out to grass. Let me lay down with me both barrels through the head.
Sadie!
I know that like I know my own name, and it plumb slipped my mind.
What a shame.
If I get like that, too, then who's gonna look out for her?
What did you say on the postcard, Aunt Sadie?
Let me figure. Been so long ago. I've been born again, she says. Love, great-grandma.
Born again? Why, that's beautiful.
Maybe. I always figured being born once was enough. Grandma, you got company. It's Jay and his wife and the others come up from Knoxville to see you. She knows ya. Come on over, Jay. I'll tell her about the rest of y'all in a minute.
Aunt Sadie, tell about the rest of us in a minute.
Now don't holler. Just talk loud and clean right up next to ear.
I know. My mother's there.
Grandma? I'm Jay, John Henry's boy.
I figure she knows ya.
She can't talk anymore, can she?
Times she can, times she can't. Ain't only so seldom called for talk. Reckon she loses the hang of it. But I figure she knows ya, and I'm tickled she does.
Come here, Rufus.
Go on, go to him.
Just call her Grandma. Talk right in her ear like Grandma Lynch. Say, Grandma, I'm Rufus.
Grandma, I'm Rufus.
Come over here and she can see you. Tell her I'm Jay's boy, Rufus.
I'm Jay's boy, Rufus.
Now kiss her.
Jay!
Let them be.
she all right?
All she knows is something's been took from her.
We won't none of us ever see great-grandma again.
I wouldn't be surprised, Pa.
The hand of death is coming close to this family.
Well, when her time comes, I would be honored to officiate free of charge.
Mama, what do you? Do you know what happened? Great-grandma had an accident. Wanda kissed her. Isn't she too old for that? Isn't she, Mama?
How's her breathing, Pa?
Pretty fair.
Sun goes down, another dollar made for Betsy Brown. Sugar Bay, Sugar Bay. There's a good old saying, Lord, everybody knows. Can't track a rabbit when there ain't no snow. Sugar Bay. Every time the sun goes down, another dollar made for Betsy Brown. Sugar Bay, Sugar Bay. Now it ain't gonna rain and it ain't gonna snow. Sun's gonna shine and the wind's gonna blow. Sugar Bay. Every time the sun goes down, another dollar made for Betsy Brown. Sugar Bay, Sugar Bay.
You sleep now, Google Eyes? What I found.
What, dear?
His old bear jacket.
Oh, dear, where'd you find him?
Over there, under the crib. He was scaring the boogeyman out of there.
The crib? Shame on me.
Poor old Jackie.
Is Rufus asleep?
Yeah, he's asleep.
What was the matter with him?
Bad dream, I reckon. Poor old Jackie. So lonesome and thrown away. You remember when I got him?
Oh, of course I do. You took such a pleasure in picking him out.
The little Jackie was bigger than Rufus. And I had to explain. It's a bear, I had to say. Only bear was too big a word in those days. Poor Jackie. I gave you too soon. And here it is too late. Left behind with the baby crib.
Well, I'm certainly glad we kept that crib. It'll save buying a new one.
Back to the corner with you, Jackie.
Don't leave it there, darling. What's the matter, Jane?
Nothing. I reckon it's just seeing great-grandma again. Remembering the summers I had out there. And seeing Pa grow so old. And watching Ralph. Feeling Rufus growing bigger and singing them sad old songs. I guess it's just the day.
It's been a long one.
Jackie's ear come off. Enough to make a man thirsty. How far we all come, Mary? How far we all come away from ourselves? So far, so much in between, you can't remember where you started or what you had in mind, where you thought you were going. All you know is you were heading someplace. you do remember. You have a boy or girl of your own. And now and then you sing to them or you hold them. And you know how they feel. It's almost as if you're your old self again. But just think, Mary. And when I was a boy, my pa used to sing to me. Before my time, even before I was dreamed of in this world, his mother, his father used to sing to him. And away on back through the mountains, past great-grandma, away on back through the years, all the way down to Adam, only nobody ever sang to Adam.
God did.
Yeah, maybe God did.
We're supposed to come away from ourselves, Jay. That's the whole point. We're supposed to come away to...
I know. To God.
I don't see how you can feel the way you do and not believe in him.
We come from people, Mary. And in time, they fall away from us, like great-grandma. We give birth to others. And in time, they grow away from us, like Rufus will. We're about 80 years old, you and me. All we're gonna have left is each other. And that's what I believe in. Maybe that's it. Maybe that's where we're heading to, each other. The sad thing is, all our lives is the distance between us. But maybe if we keep heading the direction we think is right, maybe we can't ever get all the way there. But at least we can make the distance less than it was. You'll catch cold down here like that. Let me go warm up the bed for you. Youngster on the farm. On cold nights, we all used to pile into one bed together. And finally, I was too old for all that. But I wasn't too old to cry at being left alone in a big cold bed all by myself. And my ma, she gave me her own pillow. She put it under the covers next to me. And she told me to pretend like it was one of them keeping me warm through the night and watching over me. Poor ma. She slept without a pillow for a couple months there. Now it's your turn to get the other side of the bed warm for me. Now, who in the world could that be at this time of night? Hello? Yeah, Central, this is Jay Fowler. Put him through. Hello, Ralph? Yeah, what's the trouble, Ralph? Yeah, sure, I can hear you. What's the matter? Are you crying? Pa, now listen, Ralph, I appreciate you calling in. You're not putting me out. Now tell me about Pa. I should come up, huh? Now hold on there, Ralph. Now you hold on there. If Pa's that bad, you know damn well I'm coming up, so don't give me none of that. Will you stop crying, Ralph? Now listen, Ralph, I want you to get it straight. I'm not trying to jump on you, but sometimes you like me to exaggerate. No, I don't think you're lying to me, Ralph. And no, I don't think you're drunk. I just want you to think for a minute. Just how serious is he really, Ralph? Think, goddammit! Listen, Ralph. Now, I know you wouldn't have phoned if you didn't think it was serious.
Is Sally there?
Is Sally out on the farm? And of course, Ma's there.
And how about the doctor?
And the doctor, what's he saying? Oh, well, from by the way you tell me that, it sounds like he said he's got a good chance. Now listen, Ralph, I'm stalling too much. I'm starting right on up. I ought to be there by, what time is it?
It's 11:30.
It's 11:30, Ralph. I ought to be there by 2:30. Well, I'm afraid that's the best my old tin lizard can make it. Yeah, you just tell Ma I'm coming right on up.
Is he conscious?
Is he conscious? Well, if he gets conscious, you tell him I'm coming. Now, that's all right, Ralph. And Mary understands. Appreciate you calling. That's all right, Ralph. Goodbye. Goodbye, Ralph. Oh, my God. Talking to him's like trying to put socks on an octopus.
Is it very great?
Lord knows. I can't tell anything with Ralph, but I can't afford to take the risk.
Of course not.
Now, what are you up to?
Well, I'll fix you something to eat.
I'll get something on the way if I want to.
In one of those all-night lunchrooms? Sakes alive.
It'll be quicker. Honest it will.
Well, I don't want your mother to think I don't feed you.
You see my tobacco? Oh, you had it all laid out for me.
I had to pick out which pipe I thought you'd like to take.
Well, just the one I was looking for.
It's the one I bought for you. Oh, at least you have time for a cup of coffee. It's the way you like it. The pot's choked full of old grounds and I added some new.
Now that's coffee.
I'd rather watch it drink sulfuric acid.
The outing today must have been too much for him. Paul just sits there so quiet anymore, we can't always tell what's going on underneath. He got home and just collapsed.
It's funny, Jay. Today you were saying we'd be losing your great-grandmother soon. Now it turns out your father's the one in danger.
I guess we never know who's in danger. You got a birthday coming up. What would you like to do?
Why, Jay? Why, you not saying?
You think on it. Whatever you'd like to do, within reason, of course, I'll see we manage it. That is, of course, if everything goes the way we hope or hope. I just know I have to go, so I'm anxious to get started.
Don't drive too fast.
Scribbles for him to find in the morning. First collection.
Well, maybe you should wake him up. Well, I'm afraid he's going to be disappointed you didn't tell him goodbye.
I looked in on him. I tell you what. Tell him, don't promise him anything, of course. But tell him I'm practically sure to be back before he's asleep by tomorrow night. Tell him I'll do my best.
All right, dear. Give my love to your mother. Tell her she's in my wishes and thoughts constantly. And your father, of course, if he's well enough to speak.
Don't you come any further.
Well, it was so warm this afternoon. I wish I could go with you, Jay. In whatever happens.
Well, now, why'd you add that?
Well, it's the way I feel.
I'll let you know quick as I can if it's serious. How's your money?
It's all right, thank you.
All right. Tell him I'll even try to be home before supper.
All right.
Good night.
Good night.
I keep forgetting to tell you, I want this one to be a girl.
towards tricking you. And since we're all come out here for supper, I saw no reason in going home only to come out again. So I thought I'd stop by early, Mary dear. We could have a nice, quiet chat.
Lovely, Mama.
Beg pardon?
We can have a nice, quiet chat.
Well, lovely. And of course, when your papa finds out I've been with Father Jackson, there's no telling what he'll say. Well, I simply shan't listen.
Mama.
Bathroom?
Telephone.
Oh. Hello?
Yes, Central, go ahead. Jay? Oh, Jay, darling, I've been so anxious all day. Well, how's your father? Oh, dear, then you went all the way out there for nothing? Well, there's no sense in getting angry about it. You know Ralph. Just be thankful your father's all right. Rufus, come say hello to Grandma Lynch. Where's your hat?
I forgot.
Well, get it, darling. What, dear? Oh, then you'll definitely be here for supper? Good, the family's coming up.
Give Jay my love, dear.
Yes, Mama's here already, and she sends her love. The others are coming up later. Andrew has a surprise for me that they're all being very mysterious about, so do try and make it. Well, don't hurry, not if it means driving fast, because I can hold supper. I'd rather hold it than have you race. All right, dear. See you very soon, then. Thanks for calling. Goodbye. Excuse me. Rufus, what are you doing under there? You're supposed to be at the streetcar stop.
I was looking for the surprise.
The surprise?
Daddy said it was in here someplace.
Now, darling.
Well, he did, didn't he?
Now, darling, don't ask questions. Can't keep any hand waiting. That was Daddy on the telephone, and he says Grandpa Father's going to be all right. And Daddy says he'll even be home in time for supper. You can see him before you go to bed. Isn't that wonderful? Now, what are you going to say to Aunt Hannah?
Oh, Aunt Hannah, I'm glad to go shopping.
So glad.
Oh, Aunt Hannah, I'm so glad to go shopping with you. And thank you for...
Thank you very much.
And thank you very much for thinking of me.
Now say it all together.
Oh, Aunt Hannah, I'm so glad to go shopping with you. And thank you so very much for thinking of me.
And don't forget to help her with the parcels.
You always dress him so well, Mary dear.
What's your name?
You know.
No, I don't. Tell me.
I told you yesterday.
No, honest. I don't know your name.
He wouldn't ask you if he knowed it already, would he? You're just trying to tease me.
I don't think he's got a name at all. He's a no-name nothing. No-name nothing. Leave him alone. Stop picking on him. What you mean, picking on a little kid like that? Just pick on someone your own size.
I didn't mean nothing.
Don't pay no attention to them. Want to try it? What you putting your hand out for?
So you can shake it.
I'll tell you what. I'll shake it if you tell me your name.
I'll tell you my name if you'll answer a question.
What question?
Gotta promise to answer first.
Cross my heart and body. Now what's your name?
It's Rufus.
Nigger bang!
Neither. I got it from my great-grandpa Lee.
Then your grandpa's a nigger too.
It's our great-grandpa's
afternoon, ma'am.
We gotta go.
Yeah, time.
Wait, you didn't answer my question.
Never mind, Rufus. Well, see what I brought you. There are chocolate drops in there, Rufus. Speckled pen is not a know what all. I was almost late picking them out.
Thank you, Aunt Hannah.
Don't you think it'd be polite to offer me one?
Do you like a piece of my candy, Aunt Hannah?
Well, thank you, Rufus, for thinking of me. I'd like a chocolate drop if you pick one out. My eyes, you know. How many streetcars have we missed?
I don't know.
What was that question you're going to ask those boys? Perhaps I can help you.
Mama says you've got a surprise coming to her house.
Why are we going to ask those boys about it?
Because Daddy said if Mama didn't tell me, the other boys were in the streets.
I see. And your Mama didn't tell you?
She and Daddy had a fight about it. Now Mama won't let me ask questions at all.
Oh. Rufus, aren't you going to eat your candy?
The teacher says we should send things to the Belgian orphans.
Well, that's very generous of you. But I bought the candy for you in case you should get tired of traipsing from store to store. We have a great deal of shopping to do this afternoon. It's your mother's birthday and we need to buy a scarf. Now you mustn't tell. And you have to buy a gram of ornament for your Uncle Andrew. And bunion pads for me. And hooks.
Can I watch you pair of your bunions?
We'll see. For the time being, I'm sure those orphans wouldn't mind if you had one piece of that candy.
Would you like another piece of my candy, Aunt Hannah?
Well, thank you. Speckled penny this time, I think.
What do those boys know about the surprise that's coming to your house, Aunt Hannah? Did Daddy tell them?
Of course not. They don't know a thing.
Daddy said they did.
Well, he didn't mean they knew exactly. He just meant they... Rufus, I'm sure your mother saw to it you didn't leave the house without a clean handkerchief this morning.
Can I clean your glasses, Aunt Hannah?
Promise to be very careful.
I promise.
All right. I'll hold the candy. Rufus, I know about the surprise.
You do?
Oh, yes. And I could tell you about it. There are certain things that should only be told by certain people. For instance, your teacher should be the only one to tell you about arithmetic, because she knows all about it. And a priest, or a minister, should be the one to tell you about God. He's a man of God. And your mama and daddy are the only ones to tell you about this particular surprise. Well, those others would be willing to tell you if you asked them. But you mustn't ask them.
Why not, Aunt Hannah?
Because they wouldn't tell it right.
Wouldn't you tell it right?
Breathe on the lenses, child, that's right. You wait for your mama to explain. You'll be glad later on. There you are. What is that bunch of lace under your jacket?
My kite.
Well, put it on. And does your mother buy your clothes? Millers. Women's clothes cut to fit little boys. When we're done with our shopping on Gay Street today, we're going on Market Street.
Mom won't go on Market Street.
Well, we're going into Harbison's there. I hear they're very sporty. And I'm going to buy you a cap. Or is there something else you'd rather have?
No.
Well, we'll see. Now, Rufus, the gentleman takes Letty out for an afternoon to shop, and he's the one to pay for everything. I'm going to let you carry my money. First, we need the streetcar fares. Let's see his. Ready? 5 cents for you, 5 cents for me. Or would you rather walk, and then you can keep the streetcar fares for yourself?
Oh, Aunt Hannah, I'm so glad to go shopping with you. And thank you so very much for thinking of me.
Your mama told you to say that, didn't she?
I forgot.
I know a direct quotation when I hear it.
Thank you. copy and walk.
What the devil do you think you're playing anyway?
The Burning of Rome.
Well, let's hear it then.
Oh, Rufus is asleep.
Oh, good God.
You know, Papa, we got to face the possibility, you and I, that Jay is drunk somewhere and be ready
all
for
right.
it. Mary's thinking it, though, ever since supper. And she's worried, I can tell, Papa. She's got what Jay calls that pursed up look. Shall I go and look for him?
Where would you look?
Well, you used to like those places down off Market Square. Oh, it's lively down there now, Papa, with the farmers rolling into town and the smell of salt and fresh vegetables and leather and whiskey.
Well, if that's where he is, let the man come home on his own. It will be hard enough for him when he gets back. Now, you might as well learn, Andrew. It's the way of all women to try to break their men with piety.
Or it's the way of our men, Papa, to try to break their women with impiety. I'm only asking. I've never been able to decide who I am. Your sons or mamas?
Well, not everyone has such a wide choice, Andrew.
Rufus is finally asleep. He was terribly disappointed Jay hadn't come home.
Be along soon.
Do you think I've been deserted, Papa? Do you think my husband's gone away never to return? Will you take care of me again, Papa, if I'm deserted? Will you let me come home again and sit on your lap and cry for my lost love?
No, daughter.
Why not?
Why, because you'll never be deserted.
You always defend Jay, don't you, Papa?
I always thought highly of him from the first.
You praise Jay to the skies on the one hand, and on the other, why, practically in the same breath, you'll be telling me one reason after another why it would be plain foolhardy to marry him.
Well, now, isn't it possible that I meant both things?
Well, I don't see how.
You learned how yourself, Mary.
Oh, is that what I've learned?
Well, I've taken Jay into the office. That shows confidence.
And he's teaching himself law. Your confidence is justified.
That's what I wanted to hear. You defend him.
Me defend him? Well, Papa, I could never defend Jay enough. These past few months, we've come to a kind of harmoniousness that is just so beautiful. Well, I have no business talking about it. It's just the gulfs between us. If I could fill them in, it would all be perfect. I want life to be perfect, Papa. Why doesn't he come home? Andrew, I'm ready for that present now.
You know, I shouldn't make you wait for your birthday, Mary. It was meant to be a birthday present.
What is it, a new picture you've done?
Oh, I think you're gonna like it, Mary.
Yes, Mary.
You've all seen it?
Yes. You're just gonna be so proud of him when you see it, darling.
Oh, pardon me, Andrew.
Mama, could we have a nice fanfare for the unveiling?
Oh, she didn't hear you, Andrew.
Mama, Andrew wonders if you could play a fanfare. Oh, Andrew! It's Jay!
Do you like it?
Oh, it is Jay.
I think Andrew caught a very good likeness.
Yes, especially around the mouth and the chin.
That's right, into that, especially.
Well, the eyes were the hardest. They always are unless the subject sits for you. And I didn't want Jay to do that because then you'd both have known. I've been making sketches for months.
Oh, he wouldn't have done it anyhow. Imagine Jay sitting still for an artist.
Picture has great dignity.
So has Jay.
Oh, Andrew, I just love to thank you. Daddy! Oh, dear.
I guess we were making a racket.
Did Daddy come home yet?
No, dear, what made you think so?
I woke up. I wanted to show my new cane.
Rufus, I told you not to wear that cap to bed.
And Hannah, I'll never forgive you.
Rufus, come give your grandma a good hug. Oh.
Nice little boy.
Mary, dear, do you think you ought to wear his cap to bed?
Maybe that's Jay.
Bathroom?
Telephone.
Oh.
Hello?
Come on, Rufus. Let your grandma put you to bed this time.
Can you speak a little louder? I can't hear you.
It's long distance, all right.
Dear as father's was.
At least we know where he is.
Yes, that's better, thank you. Yes, this is she. What is it? Yes, I heard you. Yes, there's my brother. Where should he come to? Brannock's blacksmith shop. Do you have a doctor? A doctor, do you have one? All right, then. My brother will be there just as soon as he can. Thank you very much for calling. Goodbye. Andrew Lesbeth, there was a man from Powell Station, and he says James met with a terrible accident. He says he wants a man of the family to help him bring him in, I guess.
Shall I get Dr. DeKalb?
He says no. Just you.
Oh, well, I guess there's a doctor already there.
Oh, yeah, I guess so.
Where do I go?
Powell Station. Left of the...
I know, but exactly where? Didn't he say?
Brannick's Blacksmith Shop. B-R-A-N-N-I-C-K. He says they'll keep the line on and you can't miss it. It's just this side of Bell's Bridge.
I won't be any longer than I have to.
Bless you. We'll get everything ready, you know, in case it's well enough to be brought home.
Good, good. I'll phone the minute I know anything. Anything.
Bless you, dear.
Where was he hurt, Mary?
He didn't say.
Well, now, didn't you ask?
Sure. Where's Mama?
Ma'am. She's upstairs with Rufus, Mary.
Keep her up there, will you, Papa? Make sure Rufus is asleep. Be sure he's asleep. Then tell her what happened. Be sure you talk softly, but loud enough so she can hear what you're saying.
Would you like us to go home, Mary?
No.
Well, then, we'll keep out of the way.
Oh, it's not that. It's just that with Mama sometimes it's so very hard to talk.
Heaven's sakes, Joe, go along.
What time is it, Hen?
About 10:25.
Let's see. Well, Andrew drives pretty fast, though not as fast as Jay. But he'll be driving better than usual tonight, and it's just over 12 miles. Oh, let's see. Supposing he goes 30 miles an hour. 6 times 4 is 24. 6 times 5 is 30. Twice 12 is 24. Six alive! I was always dreadful with figures.
It's only 12 miles. We should hear very soon.
Let's have some tea.
Why not let me?
What?
Just let me know if there's anything I can help.
Not a thing, thank you. We'll make up the bedroom downstairs. Remember you stayed there when his poor back was sprained? It's better than upstairs. We have the bathroom and the kitchen and no stairs to climb. It's the only thing, we must get the bathroom upstairs, but we never do. And of course, if need be, that is, if he needs a nurse, we can always put her in here and eat in the kitchen. Or we could just put her in the room with him and set up a screen in between, don't you think so?
Certainly.
Oh, she could always sit and sleep on the cot in the living room. Would you like some tea? Sugar and lemon with your tea? Or lemons?
Just milk will do.
Well, let me get some zuzus.
Just tea is fine. Mary, I hope you don't mind me giving Rufus that cat.
Oh, heavens, no. You were good to do it.
I'm sure if you'd realized how much you wanted one, you'd have given it to me yourself a long time ago.
Oh, of course. Yes. But Harbison's, isn't that where he got it? I hear it's so tough, how'd you have a deer go in?
Fortunately, I'm so blind, I couldn't see what might hurt me. I just said hello to the nearest man and said, pardon me, sir, but where do I go to find a cap for my nephew? He said, I'm no clerk, ma'am, I'm a customer myself. And I said, well, why aren't you wearing a hat?
Why didn't he tell me?
Who?
The man on the telephone, why didn't I ask? I didn't even ask. Where's he hurt? How serious? Father noticed it.
He couldn't think, Mary.
Is he living or dead?
We simply have to wait and find out.
Of course we have to wait. That's what makes it so unbearable.
Try if you can to find a little mercy in it.
A mercy?
A little time to prepare ourselves.
Of course, Aunt Hannah. You're quite right.
I'm going down to see if this is something I can do for poor dear Mary. But it's my place too, isn't it, Joe?
I don't really know as I want anything. But I think it's a good idea to drink something warm while we wait, don't you?
I'd like some.
I've decided there is no cause for alarm, Mary, dear. Jay's perfectly all right. Andrew was simply too overjoyed at the leap to bother to phone him. He's bringing Jay home instead for a wonderful surprise. That would be just like Andrew. And like Jay to go along for the surprise and enjoy it. Slap it how scared we've been. Of course, we shall have to scold them both. Joe, what Andrew's doing is to bring Jay's poor body into the undertaker's. Robert's problem. Although they do say the new man over on Euclid Avenue is very good. Your family has always used Robert.
Oh, did Rufus pick out that cap all by himself?
Well, you don't think I chose that monstrosity, do you? Yeah. First, you picked out a very genteel little serge, but I smelled the hypocrisy behind it. Well, forgive an old woman, Mary. And I said, do you really like that cap, or are you just trying to please your mother? Then I revealed his true taste. I was switched if I was to Boston.
Either he's badly hurt but he lived, or it's so hurt, terribly hurt that he'll die from it. Maybe after a long, terrible struggle, he'll be breathing his last at this very moment, wondering where I am, why I'm not there. Or he was already dead when the man called. Of course, it's just what I have no earthly business guessing about.
Certainly not.
And I won't say he's dead until I know that he is for sure. I'm all concerned he is the same. Oh, I do beseech my God that it be not so. Aunt Hannah, can we kneel down and pray together? Aunt Hannah!
No, Mary.
Why not?
It's too easy. As you say, it's one thing or the other. No matter what it is, there is not one thing in this world or the next that we can do, a hope, a wish, or pray for that'll do to change it one iota. Because whatever it is, is. And all there is now is to be ready for it, strong enough for it. That's all that's possible, because that's all there is.
I'm trying to be ready.
Your beliefs have never been truly tested, Mary. God's come easily to you. He's going to come harder now. If you wait until you can't go on without him, you'll find him. And when you have to pray, we'll pray.
For goodness sakes, why don't I get that room ready?
It's your turn, Mary.
What time is it, Joe?
12:45, 12:45.
Andrew's had time to get there and back, hasn't he?
Twice.
Don't shout at me. Just speak distinctly and I can hear you. Just think, Joe. He'll be a posthumous baby.
Why, we haven't had a posthumous baby in the family since your cousin Hetty, yes. Uncle Henry was killed in the war between the states.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth.
Mary.
He's dead, Andrew, isn't he? He was dead when you got there.
He was instantly killed.
Oh, Mama! Papa!
Oh, there, Mary. There.
Sit down, Mary.
It's hell, Mary. Just plain hell.
Instantly, Papa. Instantly. He was in this blacksmith shop and they made me look at him instantly. This reeking horse blanket and they made me look. I ain't never seen a dead man before and it was Jay. Instantly,
for
Papa.
For God's sakes, Andrew, think of your sister.
Andrew? What happened?
Give yourself a minute, Mary. Just a minute.
Just to clear your head.
I don't want it, Mama! I want to hear what happened. Andrew?
I have to tell you?
Taylor.
I can't be the one.
What happened?
I don't even know how to begin.
Just begin.
Where?
Anywhere.
Well, he was alone for one
thing.
Well,
of course he was alone, I know that.
I just meant there was no one else in the accident, or the automobile.
What caused the accident?
A cotter pin.
Oh, what's a cotter pin?
You wouldn't understand, Mary. You don't know.
Papa, make him tell me.
All right. It's just something that holds the steering mechanism together like this. And that's what, and there'd be a hole through the knuckles, and that's where the cotter pin goes.
I understand.
Well, the cotter pin fell out.
What happened then?
Nobody was there. We can't say.
Well, who found him?
The man who telephoned you.
Well, who was he?
I don't know his name.
I wish you did.
He said he was driving into town about 9 o'clock. And all of a sudden, he heard Jay coming up behind you, terrific fast.
Well, where was this?
Just the other side of Bell's Bridge.
Where it comes to that sort of angle?
That's the place. See, he'd been thrown absolutely clear of the auto as it ran off the road. And it went up an 8-foot embankment. And it came back down beside him without even grazing it. And I think that when his cotter pin fell out, he must have been thrown forward very hard, so it struck his chin one shot blow against the steering wheel. And that must have been what killed him.
Killed? I'll never see him again. Never.
Hey there, Mary. We're all here.
Thank goodness for that, Mom. Andrew? I'll walk with you.
It'll do us good.
It'll do us all good.
Well, I'll go down home and get some.
No. The book here. Andrew, what did he look like?
His clothes were hardly even ruffled.
His brown suit.
He was lying on his back.
His face?
Just a little blue bruise in the lower lip.
Is that all?
And a cut so small they can sew it up at one stitch.
Where?
The exact point of his chin.
Point of his chin, Papa.
The doctor said death was instantaneous. Concussion of the brain. He can't have suffered for even a second, Mary. I asked about that very particularly because I knew you'd want to be sure. I saw his face and there wasn't a glimmer of pain in it. only a kind of surprise, startled.
Well, I imagine so.
It was just a chance in a million. Just that one tiny area, that certain sharpness of impact.
Shut up, Andrew!
What'd that say?
Have a little mercy! A little mercy!
I'm so sorry, Mary.
Let her cry.
I'm so sorry.
Oh, God, forgive me. Forgive me! It's just more than I can bear. Forgive me.
Forgive you? I say, oh God, if you do exist, God damn you!
Andrew!
Mary, listen to me. Listen to me. There is nothing to ask forgiveness for. There is nothing to ask forgiveness for, Mary. Do you hear me?
I spoke to him as if he had no mercy.
Andrew was just trying to help.
To God. As if he were trying to rub it in, torment me. That's what I was asking forgiveness for. There, there, Mary.
Mary, listen to me. Our Lord on the cross, do you remember?
God, why hast thou forsaken me?
Yes. And then did he ask forgiveness?
He was God, he didn't have
to. He was man also. He didn't ask it. Nor was it asking him to ask it. No more are you. No more should you. You're wrong, Mary, you're terribly mistaken. Or was it he said instead, the very next thing?
Father, into thy hands.
Father, into thy hands, I commit my spirit.
I command. You never had anything but God, Aunt Hannah. I had a husband. I was married to a man. I won't have God in this place. Oh, that picture! I never saw that face before tonight. Jay's face had eyes and a mouth. Put it in the other room, Papa.
Try not to suffer too much, Mary, dear.
That's right, Mama. Keep your aunt trumpet in your lap. Shut out whatever might be unpleasant. Think of having voices to hear and not listening. I want more whiskey.
Let me fix you a good hot toddy so you sleep.
I want a lot more whiskey.
You make yourself drunk, Mary.
Let me.
It's tomorrow to reckon with.
What's tomorrow? I'm gonna get just as drunk as I can.
Mother always said that in times of stress, the best thing to drink was buttermilk.
Buttermilk!
Oh, Mama. Buttermilk? Oh.
Buttermilk!
Mom, buttermilk.
What are we all laughing about?
Buttermilk.
Well, now, what's so funny about buttermilk?
Well, I never in my life have been so thoroughly shocked and astonished.
What is it?
Just listen.
What's up, Mary?
Quiet, Papa. There's something.
I can't hear anything.
Mary does.
There is something.
It's in the dining room.
I'll go and see.
Wait, Andrew, don't. Not yet.
Has somebody come into the house?
What made you think so, Mama?
How silly of me. I thought I heard footsteps. I must be getting old and different.
It's Jay.
Of course it is.
What?
He's coming to the room with us.
Mary.
It's Jay, Andrew. Who else would come here tonight? So terribly worried and concerned for us. Oh, and restless. Feel the restlessness.
You mean you can feel?
I mean, it simply feels like it's present.
Do you feel anything, Papa?
I feel goosebumps, of course. But that's from looking at your faces. Mary, you gotta stop this.
Quiet, Papa. He's in Rufus's room.
For God's sake, Mary, you're having hallucinations.
Don't I know that God in a wheelbarrow wouldn't convince you, but Mary knows what she's experiencing.
Well, I believe it. I really do.
Oh, I see. You've decided whose son you
please
are.
Please stop talking about it, please. It just means so much more than we can say. I'd like to be quiet in the house. By myself.
Now it ain't gonna rain, now it ain't gonna snow.
Andrew, when you get home, will you telephone Jay's people and tell them how it happened?
Andrew? Where is he? Dear God, where is he?
What do you mean?
Where'd you bring him to?
Oh. Well, it's Roberts.
Roberts? Yes. Bless you.
Up at your fat, smug, fat face. I couldn't help myself.
Oh, well, thanks, honey. That's quite an apology.
He said.
She.
Yours too.
His name's in the paper? Rufus's?
Him and his daddy both. Right in the paper.
He was killed instantly.
What you get for driving an auto when you're drunk, that's what my daddy says.
What's drunk?
What's drunk? Drunk is for a good old whiskey.
After what drunk is?
Then he wasn't.
How do you know?
Because my daddy never walked like that.
How'd he get killed if he wasn't drunk?
He had a fatal accident.
How'd he have a fatal accident if he wasn't drunk?
It was a concussion.
Don't even know how his own daddy got killed.
My dad says we gotta feel sorry for Rufus here, because he's an orphan.
I am?
Sure, like the Belgian kids, only worse, because that's war. And my daddy said any kid that's made an orphan just because his daddy gets drunk is a poor kid.
He says his daddy wasn't drunk.
Yeah.
Maybe he was a little.
Is that so?
I remember now.
Sure he was.
Good old whiskey.
Poor kid. My daddy says his old tin lids and run up an 8-foot embankment.
That's all you know about it.
Let him tell it.
Yeah, you tell him, Rufus.
Well, come on and tell us then.
Well, it wasn't any old tin lids my daddy was driving in the first place. It was a Chalmers.
Ooh.
And my daddy was going like 60.
Ooh. Because he was drunk.
Good old whiskey.
Poor kid.
My daddy's didn't run up any 8 foot in back of what you said either. Ran up a pole.
A pole?
100 feet high.
What kind of a pole is that?
The North Pole. Up there. If squint your eyes, you can see. Can you see?
Oh, yeah.
You see it.
And my dad is all ran up it. Fell right back on top of my jet lock. Wah! And that joggled his brain, loosened his head, and it fell out. And the hand of death came down out of the sky and scooped it up. Now that's a concussion.
Hey, it's getting late.
Yeah, well, we gotta go, Rufus, so long.
That's a nice new cat you got there, Rufus.
We'll be seeing you, Rufus. Bye.
The North Pole! The North Pole!
P-R-O-U-T. C-R-A-V-E. P-R-O-U-T. C-R-A-V-E. P-R-O-U-T. C-R-A-V-E. He is survived by his wife, Mary. Mom has a Navy in the pipe. And a son, Rufus, me. My dad is dead. Wow. Can't ever come home. Not tomorrow. Oh, the next day. Oh, the next day. Oh, the next day. Mom! My dad is dead. Mom! My daddy's dead.
Oh, darling. Now, Rufus, Aunt Hannah's gonna take you to Grandma Lynch's for the rest of the morning. Mama will come by later so we could go see Daddy last one time. So you could say goodbye. You'd be very quiet and very good.
How could you have a fatal accident if you wasn't drunk?
Hannah!
Mama.
Everybody, I'm gonna see us through this grievous day. Jim Wilson, you're gonna spend the day with your cousin Rufus. Play nice with him. Andrew, my Shambers is right out front. I'm gonna drive Mary and Paul and Ma. You follow me with the others. Are y'all right, Paul? Try to be brave, Ma. Try to be brave.
Just leave me be, Ralph.
Cry your heart out, Ma. It's natural at a time like this. I'm gonna be two sons to you now. I'm gonna be as many sons as you want.
Just leave me be.
If anybody needs me, I'll be right outside.
so bad about my dress, Mother Fowler. You look fine, Sally. Still, I wish it were black. Imagine being young enough not to have a black dress. Imagine that, Ms. Lynch.
What is it, Joe?
Black dresses.
Oh. Is anybody speaking?
No, Catherine.
Well, when I was a girl in Michigan, the milliner and the dressmaker used to come to the house. Why, they were almost the first to arrive. Well, after the priest, of course, but before the undertaker, they filled in that gap. And no one ever knew how they knew when to arrive, for they were never summoned. They just appeared as if they had an extra sense about such things. And they always wore purple to show they weren't of the tragedy, but in sympathy to it. I'll finish now.
If a woman has a usual life, one black dress will see her through it.
Beg pardon?
She really don't hear good, do she?
In Japan, they say white is the color of mourning.
Now that wouldn't seem right.
Well, now black wouldn't seem right to them.
You all right, Paul?
There's Grandma sitting up on that mountain for 103 years. Here's me, two tax my credit, still Jay's one that gets took, not Jay, never Jay.
Now Paul,
I was all ready to go.
There he is, the poor little fatherless child.
I saw my dad.
Now don't you cry, honey. Your Uncle Ralph is here.
Ralph, I'd like you to meet Father Jackson. This is my brother-in-law, Mr. Fowler.
How do you do? Well,
how do you do, sir? Can I take your hat?
Thank you.
That won't be necessary, Father. We'll be leaving again directly.
Was everything all right down to Robert's, Mary? Now, what do you think of that, sir? With the deceased's only brother an undertaker and willing to do the generous thing free of charge, she still puts him in the hands of a stranger. Did you ever hear of such a thing, Zach?
It's right for your brother to be buried here, Mr. Follett, where his home was.
Now, that just plain don't make sense. Jay spent over 2/3 of his life in Lafayette, less than 1/3 in Knoxville. I figured it out. You just don't think of me. You never even thought of me, did you?
No!
My own brother, my only brother!
Husband.
Well, it's all right for you, Mary. It's all right for you.
There's little Rufus.
I saw my daddy.
Come to Grandma, Rufus.
Oh, come sit on Grandma's lap, Rufus.
Well, I never.
She didn't hear you, Mrs. Follett. No offense.
I keep forgetting.
Is it time, Mary?
Yes, Papa.
I'll just put Jim Wilson in Rufus's room. If that's all right with you, Mary?
It's all right, Sally. Rufus, Mama has to go away for a little while. You're to be a very good boy and stay here with Grandma Lynch.
I'm glad he's dead!
Was it drunk?
Mary.
On top of everything else, a priest?
Was my husband drunk?
I'll fall in the hands of a priest!
Was it drunk? I have to know. You were with him all day, tell me!
I ain't gonna tell you, Mary. Oh, you thought of me. You thought of me all right the night he died, even. And you just didn't want me. I ain't gonna tell you nothing!
We must go, Mary.
Nothing!
What's she gonna do?
Ralph, are you all right to drive?
Well, nobody else is gonna drive my shamblers, let me tell you.
Mary, the service is due to start in a very few minutes.
I'm staying right here in this room.
You want me to send Father Jackson?
No.
Is she coming?
No.
Be long in a minute, Andrew. Get everybody else in the car.
Why don't they all leave? You two and Hannah, but I'm not going.
Stay in here.
If you are, please don't touch me. That miserable rat, damn it!
You were right, Hannah. God is coming harder to me now. And Jay, too. I can't seem to find either one of them. This tie was bought in Chattanooga someplace. When do you suppose? Sometimes when he went off like that, he was said to be a scene as far as Clearwater County. But Chattanooga, whatever made Jay do whatever, that man who moved into this house, where did he go? And when he first went to work in Papa's office, not when Rufus was born, though. He was very dearly close to me then, very. But other times, he'd feel himself being closed in. Watched by superintendents, he'd say. There was always a special quietness about him afterwards when he came home. As if he was very far away from where he was going. But very far away from me, too. Keeping his distance, but working his way back.
The man rests, Mary.
I want to let him rest.
Aren't you even going to attend his funeral?
You think I'll rest by simply lowering him into the ground? I won't watch it. How can he when he was lost on the very day he died?
You don't know if he was lost, a drunk, or what he was.
No. That's exactly what I don't know.
And that's exactly what you can't bear.
I never knew. Not for sure. There were times that we all knew about, of course, but there were other times when it wasn't always the whiskey. He'd be gone for a day, or a night or two, and I know he hadn't touched a drop. And it's not any of the other things that come to a woman's mind in case you're thinking that.
I'm not thinking that, Mary.
Those are easy enemies. It was Market Square. And talking to country people about country secrets that go way on back through the mountains. And anyone who'd sing his old songs with him. And it was all night lunchrooms. What's an all night lunchroom for except for sitting all night, he'd say? And drink coffee so hot it would burn your ribs. And it was locomotives, I suppose. And railroad people and going fast. And even Charlie Chaplin. What's wrong with Charlie, he'd say, not because he didn't know what I'd say, but to make me say it. He's so nasty and vulgar with his nasty little cane-looking upskirts. And Jay would laugh and go off and see Charlie Chaplin and then not come home. Where he went, I never knew, for he never told me. It was always easy to put everything down to whiskey.
Put it down to an enemy.
Why couldn't I let him have those things, whatever they were? If they meant something to him. Why can't I let him have them now? But dear, he always worked his way back.
Aunt Hannah, we can't wait any longer.
All right, Aunt.
I'm glad Ralph didn't tell me. I must just accept not knowing, mustn't I? I must let Jay have what I don't know. What if he was drunk? What the world if he was? Did I honestly think that was a ghost?
he was drunk, Hannah? Just if he was. I hope he loved me. Speeding along at the night, singing at the top of his lungs. Racing because he loved to go fast. Racing us because he loved us. And for the time enjoying. Reveling in a freedom that was his, that no person or place or nothing in this world could ever give him or take away from him. Let's hope that's how it was, Hannah. How he looked death itself in the face. In his strength. That's what we'll put on the gravestone, Aunt Hannah. In his strength.
New cap.
He's an orphan.
What are all these riches coming down from the sky?
Those are letters and presents from children all over the world because they feel sorry for him.
Oh. Why, Rufus, someday you may be an artist like Uncle Andrew. For the time being, of course, I think it would be polite for you to say you want to study law like your grandfather did and as your dear father was doing. That would only be showing respect.
Regis mealy-mouthed son of a bitch! I tell you, Andrew, it's enough to make a man wrench up his soul.
And was it a lovely funeral, dear?
That Jackson! Father Jackson, as he insists on being called. Why not a word would he say over Jay's body, let alone read a service? Because he'd never been baptized. A rule of the church, some church.
Andrew. Is this something I should be hearing?
Absolutely not, Mama. Come on, Rufus.
You come to one single, simple act of Christian charity, and what happens? The rules of the church forbid it. Why, he's not a member of our little club, they say. Well, now I only care, mind you, for Mary's sake.
Joe, I don't know what you're saying. But I wish you wouldn't say it, dear. Just wait until we get home. Well, what you say doesn't matter.
Good God.
I tell you, Rufus, if anything ever makes me believe in God or life after death, it'll have to be what happened this afternoon at Greenwood Cemetery. See, there was lots of clouds. They were blowing fast. And so there was lots of sunshine, too. And right when they began to lower your father into the ground, into his grave, cloud come over and there was a shadow just like iron. And a perfectly magnificent butterfly settled on the coffin. Just rested there. Just barely making his wings breathe like a heart. And he stayed there all the way down, Rufus, until it grated against the bottom like a rowboat. And just when it did, the sun come out just dazzling bright. And he flew out up out of that hole in the ground so high up into the sky, I couldn't even see him anymore. Don't you think that's wonderful, Rufus?
Yes, sir.
I tell you, if there's any such things as miracles, then that's surely miraculous. A damn miracle. Thank you.
people there, Papa. Did you notice? I didn't know half of them. We don't always realize, do we, how many others love the people we love. Rufus says my face looks like my best china teacup. You know, Hannah, the one Jay mended for me so many times.
Yes.
He's beginning to say things like that now. And I don't know where he gets it. People fall away from us. And in time, others grow away from us. That's simply what living is, isn't it?
Why don't you rest,
Mary? Oh, you're the one who haven't stopped for 3 days.
I'm not tired.
You must be dead. The words that come to mind.
Not dead. Older, perhaps. But I'm content.
Well, you'll lay down for just a minute.
There's supper to be fixed for them
not
now.
Not yet.
Have just a moment.
Hannah, I love and revere everyone in this world who has ever suffered. I truly do, even if they fail to endure.
I like the way you call me Hannah now instead of Aunt Hannah.
We're that much closer.
You let me know when it's time to get started again.
Well, I'll let you know.
What did they say, Catherine?
They said how fortunate we have been, you and I, to have lived so many years without losing each other.
Oh, I did say that then.
I must have been mistaken.
Oh, you were mistaken, Catherine. That's what I said.
Never mind, dear.
Breathing, Pa.
Pretty fair.
You can almost feel summer coming on.
At last.
Andrew, there's just one more thing. Will you keep an eye on Ralph for the rest of the day?
Oh, Mary.
Well, he has to try the family box to La Follette tonight, and goodness sakes, we don't want any accidents. My, you can almost see all the way to North Knoxville.
Ma'am.
What, dear?
We, sir.
What are you trying to say?
We survived, didn't we, ma'am?
Why, yes, darling, we survived.
Am I an orphan?
An orphan?
Like the Belgians?
Rufus, orphans don't have either a father or a mother.
Am I half an orphan, ma'am?
Rufus, orphans don't have anyone to love them or take care of them. Oh, darling, and you do. Mama's wanted to see more of you these last few days, a lot more. But you know how much she loves you, don't you?
the dollar, heart, and soul.